This is the hive that is being donated to the essay winner who wanted to have bees this year. And so I'm just going to go ahead and take apart this hive that was donated to us from Jeff. So here I am. I'm going to pull the 10 frames and the queen for the essay winner.
Have a method of the way I do things. Propolis! All this orange stuff around the edges right here, all the sticky stuff that you're seeing, it's all propolis. Propolis is how I prefer to say it, but to each their own. And then this is their honey super. So there's honey in here. We're going to give that back to Jeff so he can earn back all the effort he put into these lovely ladies. So I am going to set this off to the side. I'm just checking. So I'm looking at all these frames. They're not completely done with it. They're still building some out. So they're still filling this up. It's not ready to extract yet. All right, and then I'm just going to go through. I'm pulling 10 frames. I realize now this is an 8 frame, but no big deal. So this is capped brood and eggs. Capped brood and eggs. And off the base. There's small hyveals, push that. And it looks like I saw a cell. Let's see what that looks like. Nope. Okay. So no queen on here. Smoke blowing directly on them. So capped brood and more eggs. Pollen and honey. So I'm actually going to put the pollen and honey out this way because I want the brood to be towards the inside. This is a lot of drone. And then pollen and honey. It does have a lot of capped brood on it, but I wouldn't say this is the best frame. So I'm going to set this one back in the box. I don't want to give somebody a bunch of drone. I'm just seeing some gorilla. All right. So lots more eggs. Brood and eggs. video recording. Is anyone over there?
No.
I heard kids and I was like, oh, I hope they're kids. McKinnon called.
What?
He has bees in his soffit.
Really?
Yeah, he wants to know if we can come out and look.
Like today?
I told him if we got home in time tonight we might, but unlikely depending on what time we got back. This is a frame of honey. That box has. Turkeys. You're going crazy over there. Oh, I didn't bring a bottom board yet. Do I have a bottom board out here? Alright, got a bottom board and a 10 frame. Put my bottom board there. This 10 frame box right here has 9 slots in it. So I need 10 slots. So I grab a different box. Move this over here. Alright, they are not real thrilled to see me, to be honest, right now. I've taken their hive apart for a little bit too long. Thank you. this is a good frame of pollen. I got stung in the arm, and then that set off the alarm pheromone. So two other bees decided they were going to follow me. So I just got on my suit. These bees have been messed with and bumped around and stuff since they got moved, and then they're not real happy right now. Now at this point, I'm gonna knock them down. Yeah, they're mean. Can you get Rowan? These bees are really, really mean. I've been stung like 20 times. So, look at that. Five of them just attacking my hand. Insane. Well, these bees, what I'm doing now, because I'm realizing that they're pretty nasty, I'm breaking them down into three different boxes so that I can break down their numbers to reduce how many bees they have to come after me. And then I'll go back through. This hive right here on the ground has the queen. So I'm going to come back and pull that queen out and kill her. And then I'll wait a day and I'll put in a queen from my genetics, which are much nicer bees. Bees that I would want to have on this property. And unfortunately I can't sell or I can't give away bees that are mean. I'm going to join one more bottom board. Man, I can't believe how testy they are. This doesn't happen often. guys. Y'all are majorly nasty. Can you go find him, please? He can't come over here. I mean, like, you're kind of risking where you're at. They're really nasty. All right. Stick a top on these bees and get the heck out. I broke all the hives down into three different hives of their own now. There's the bottom brood, the top brood, and then the honey super are all on separate tops and bottoms. And that weakens the colony so that their numbers aren't so high and they're not going to come out and attack in the mass amounts that they can. So in a couple days, I'll come back out and I'll go through this hive because this is the one that has the queen, and kill that queen and get rid of her because her genetics are not that nice, and I don't want bees like that in my apiary or openly mating with the wild feral colonies that are out and about. So that will happen this week. I might buy a couple queens probably from like Laura Urban if she has them, just to keep these hives going a little bit faster and ahead of the game. But these will definitely not be going to the little girl that won the bees, because I am not giving them mean bees. That's not fun. I want nice bees. It doesn't happen often, but occasionally it does. And when it does, you just get rid of those kinds of bees because you don't want to have mean and aggressive bees, or at least I don't. They say they produce more honey, but I would rather have nice bees that I can manage than an extra gallon of honey. So.